Hi, this is Bonnie from the Lavinia World YouTube design team. And today I wanted to just do some watercolor bubbles. And I just thought it would be a fun thing to do and to practice. And this is going to end up being a project for me. But I thought for right now, I'm going to show you how I did the bubbles. And I'm going to show you some of the product first. I am simply using Distress Oxide. And I'm using faded jeans, and I'm going to be using Mermaid Lagoon. There's a chance I might add a little bit of chipped sapphire too, just depending on how that shows up for me on here. The other thing you're going to need is a paper towel, a little bit of water, and a brush. One thing that I'm going to do differently is I just, when I went to do these bubbles, I just did water in a circle, and I thought for some people that might be a little confusing. So I went ahead and I grabbed some of my dyes, and I'm just gonna randomly put those on here instead of just painting water is what I was doing before. I thought this might help you better to understand what it is I'm doing. For me, it's easier just to draw the water circle. You are not going to be able to see the water that I'm putting down on here. It just doesn't show up unless I tip it to the side. And I could do that just to show you that you can see it. So what I do next is I just simply get my medium color, which is a Mermaid Lagoon. I have a little bit of water on my brush. I just get a little bit from that side. And I'm going to go down at the bottom of this, with the idea the sun is up in the right hand corner. So you just kind of like do the letter C a little bit chunky. And if you go back in and just get more of the ink, it'll make it darker. I think what I'm gonna go do and put some, I'm just gonna smash it, the ink on my board over here to the side. Then I won't have to keep dipping into the pad. But you can kind of see how that's like the letter C, and you leave a little bit of it white towards the top. You could actually draw that little line right over the top. But I'm going to go ahead and smash this a minute on the, so you can see. I'm just going to use it from there, and that'll be good. So I'm going to pick up just a little bit more of that, as you can see. And I'm just gonna come back in here towards the bottom and add some. Now, what's really cool about this, which I discovered, is that if you feel that that's too dark, that's why this paper towel comes in really handy. You just smash, I keep using the word smash, you just touch that lightly and you can pick up that color and it's not so dark. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try the faded jeans first for my shadow. And I'm just gonna put a little bit of that also on here. Okay. So you could see how relatively easy. They're an organic bubble, so they don't have to be perfect. And you can see that's a little bit dark. So I'm gonna go ahead and come in here with more water to make it spread. I want it to blend, and the water blends really well with the inks blend really well in the water. Again, that's a little bit dark for me, so I'm gonna come back in again and just pick up some of that color. And I am gonna add a little bit of this dark, a little bit. Just get it to where you're wanting it to look. I do want a little bit of a shadow down there. And if I get off of the water that was down there, it will be a little bit more of a jagged edge. But again, like I said, this is watercolor, and I don't care that it's, I actually like it, that it's a little bit more jagged, not perfect. That's why this is kind of a fun, relaxing thing just to sit here and color in bubbles. And you could have started out with smaller bubbles if you wanted to have a really smaller theme. But I am going back in here and trying to blend this other part out with a little bit more water. Water helps me blend. So that's one bubble. You can see that. Now, so I want to add a little bit more, and I'm going to go to the next size down, and I am just going to come up here. I'm going to take the middle size one and just go right there. And I'm going to get some water, just like I showed you before, and just put that water inside that circle. Think of all these things you can do with your dyes. You can actually do this kind of concept. Okay, getting a little bit of the Mermaid Lagoon. And again, if you cannot see that, you can go ahead and tip your paper slightly so you can see where that's at. Just a little bit of this faded jeans. I don't think I'm going to be needing the chipped sapphire at all. I think this is dark enough for me. I still want to get a little bit of that bubble underneath so it looks like it's going through that top bubble. You can just kind of smooth that out, make it a little bit more rounder if you want. And there you go, you've got two bubbles. And that's basically all I do to get those bubbles. I'm going to do a couple more for you to watch, and I'll speed up the video if you want to see the completed thing with all the bubbles.
Thank you.
Alright, so I've got all those bubbles put on here using the circle dies, and that seemed to work really well doing that as well. This was just totally done by hand without the dies, and then I used the dies for this. So this gives you an idea of what you can do either way, whatever works easier for you. So I'm going to go ahead and save this for my next project. And I appreciate you stopping by and watching this. And I hope you have some fun making some bubbles of your own. Please go ahead and share your links down below to what you have created with the bubbles. And also would like to remind you to go ahead and, if you haven't already, subscribe to the Lavinia World channel. And again, every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, we have tutorials that the design team make. So just wanted to say thanks again.